Hi everyone, my name is Nick Adman and I'm a program manager in the Microsoft Identity and Network Access Customer Experience Organization. In this video, I'll answer the question, what is the Microsoft Authentication Library? So you'll often see the Microsoft Authentication Library written as the acronym MSAL, MSAL, and in fact, there is actually not just one, but a set of libraries that support different languages for web, mobile, and desktop development. And their purpose is to make it easy to implement authentication and authorization in your applications. Today, I'll focus on these libraries, but we've also released a video explaining the fundamentals of authentication, which you can find using the link below. Okay, let's get into it. I'll do a bit of an overview, show you some code, and then go into more detail about the specific features of these libraries. So from a high level, the libraries are fundamentally OAuth2 and OpenID Connect libraries. They are built to handle the protocol details so that you can use simple lines of code to perform authentication and authorization. They stay up to date so that you don't need to change your code as new security updates are rolled out. And in addition to this, the libraries cache, persist, and refresh the tokens that are acquired during this process so that you don't need to think about it. So you can basically say, here's the API and the scope that I need to call it, and MSAL will figure out if you have the right token or need to do incremental consent or anything else to get the right permission. Here's an example code snippet. This is the most common pattern that you'll see with MSAL. The pattern is to sign in or get permission to access resources by acquiring a token. You first do this silently, so no user input is required. Then, if this doesn't work, you prompt the user for input, like providing credentials or performing a multi-factor authentication. The code you need to put in your app is very simple. This pattern is 90% of the interactions that you'll have with Microsoft Identity in your code. The point of all this is that the libraries are designed to make it simple to perform authentication and authorization. In fact, developers at Microsoft build products using these libraries. So that's it from a high level, but let's go point by point through some of the specifics of what you get from these libraries. Optimized SSO experience. So SSO in this case means single sign-on. Because MSAL implements the OAuth2 and OpenID Connect protocols, apps using MSAL will support signing in once and using the same accounts across apps. And you can use a variety of authentication methods, including credentials, multi-factor authentication, passwordless, FIDO2 keys, etc. Your app will also support any authentication controls the customer's organization needs to set via conditional access, which is a key feature of Azure Active Directory and the Microsoft Identity Platform. Handle the mechanics. This means MSAL handles the protocol level details for you. It also supports things like caching and refreshing tokens so that you don't need to manage token expiration. Help you troubleshoot. MSAL is built to expose actionable exceptions, logging, and telemetry to help you troubleshoot your app. Again, this helps you not have to implement things at the protocol level. Support any Microsoft identity. So you get the ability to authenticate any Microsoft identity, including work or school accounts and personal accounts. Your application can also sign in external identities, including users from other organizations, social accounts like Facebook and Google, or sign up with just an email. Quick starts and integration assistance. So when you register your apps in Azure Active Directory, you can use quick starts that give you sample code to easily get started using MSAL. And the integration assistant will help you get everything configured correctly, optimized for new innovations. So finally, MSAL uses the latest security updates, but also supports newest innovations like continuous access evaluation and conditional access authentication context. As Microsoft iterates on resilience, MSAL is in the position to take advantage of these features automatically. So that's it. I hope you found this video useful in learning what MSAL is. And I wanted to close out with some useful links. So you can use these links to learn more about MSAL and to get support developing with the libraries. Thanks for watching, and see you next time.